So this is a game changer for the treatment of aneurysms using minimally invasive techniques.
And University of Louisville Dr. Robert James was the first in Kentucky to perform that game-changing surgery on patients with brain aneurysms.
What we're doing is we're treating cerebral aneurysms through a minimally invasive technique going through the femoral artery from within the blood vessels and embolizing or occluding brain aneurysms.
An aneurysm is an enlarged, weakened area of the artery leading to the brain. If undetected or left untreated, it could rupture at any time, potentially causing severe disability, loss of brain function, or even death.
A small percentage of patients will have what we call a subarachnoid hemorrhage, which is a kind of a stroke, about a third of those patients could die before they ever get to the hospital. Another third or so will have persistent severe disabilities, and then a third will go back but still tend to have ongoing problems lifelong with fatigue and headaches and things like that.
Mary Steinhilber's three sisters had brain aneurysms. One died, and two others had complications following more traditional surgery. After Mary learned she was following in her sister's unwanted footsteps, she too had not one but three aneurysms, she decided to wait for FDA approval and UofL surgeons to have the woven endobridge or web device surgery.
I played Russian roulette and waited because I wanted this new procedure, which is so much more effective than, you know, from what my sister's going through. I could have been in the same situation. They tried coils. Oops, that didn't work. Let's try something else. And I thought, I'm going to wait for the new procedure because it's much better.
So if we can fix the aneurysm before it bursts and cure it, then the threat of this aneurysm bursting and the patient dying from this at some point in the future essentially goes away.
Mary Steinhilber is grateful for the more advanced option, requiring only an overnight stay in the hospital and follow-up care from Kimberly Meyer and the doctors at UofL.
Well, we like to think of ourselves as a leader in cerebrovascular. We have many studies going on. We want to offer our patients the state-of-the-art therapies.
And I've been through my procedure, and apparently I'm fixed and all set for the rest of my life, I hope.